It's going to be a big deal Saturday in Riverside. It's why these guys are working like heck. They're getting ready to dedicate a baseball field, not for a slugger with big muscles or a pitcher with blazing speed or a philanthropist with deep pockets. This park will be named for a guy who picked up boxes, who made the coffee, who laced the gloves. His name was Bernie Stowe.
Bernie Stowe is like anybody else as far as being a hitter or a great pitcher. Bernie's the best at what he does.
Pete said that in 1986. Bernie had worked for the Reds for nearly 40 years by then, doing less than glamorous work. Let's see you clean 500 towels and 70 uniforms every day.
The washer starts around 8:30 and doesn't quit about 7:30 at night.
He didn't complain. He knew his job from the time he started as a bat boy in the late 40s. Bernie was running the clubhouse by 58, making sure everything was in tip-top shape, keeping the egos of the machine in check, making friends, and trading jabs.
Bernie Stowe is special because of the person that he is and the person that he's been since I've known him, since 1967, and that's never changed.
That was said in 2003. The Reds had a new ballpark, and they named the clubhouse after Bernie. It was noted that he was part of some 5,000 wins over more than a half century.
Seems like yesterday, Papa. Hell, he does.
Bernie left us 2 years ago, but the Reds and its community fund never forgot what he brought to the game. So, not far from where Bernie grew up and where he raised a family, they made over a baseball field. They've been working feverishly through this temperamental spring to get it done. So now he'll have his own field to go with his own clubhouse. But he already had something much better than that.
My congratulations to the best man I know.
Bernie Stowe had respect because of what he did and who he was. In Cincinnati, and in fact anywhere, you can't ask for more than that.